Hello and welcome. With two or more cameras, you can obtain 3D information about the surface of objects. For example, distance images or 3D surfaces. In this tutorial, you'll learn what to consider when configuring your setup, how to calibrate the stereo setup, and how to check the quality of the calibration results. First, let's take a closer look at the hardware setup. One important factor is the required depth of field, that is, the range where the object is in focus. To achieve a larger depth of field, you can, for example, use a lens with a shorter focal length. However, this reduces the working distance and increases the field of view. Alternatively, you can use a smaller aperture. This will, however, require a longer exposure time or stronger illumination. The illumination should be diffuse, avoiding reflections as much as possible. Increasing the distance of the cameras from the object also increases the depth of field. Another important aspect is the triangulation angle, the angle between the cameras. A larger angle provides better accuracy. However, a larger triangulation angle might also lead to more surfaces that are not seen by at least two cameras, and therefore cannot be reconstructed. With HALCON, you have a lot of hardware options. You can mix different camera types and use more than two cameras to achieve suitable results. For stereo reconstruction, it's important that the surfaces of the objects are textured. If your object shows little texture, you can use a random pattern projector that creates an artificial texture and thus improves stereo reconstruction. Now, let's perform a stereo calibration by using HALCON. For this, I prepared this HDevelop script. The general workflow is as follows. We place a calibration plate in the field of view and acquire images synchronously. HALCON locates the calibration marks and stores them in a calibration data model. Based on this data, the calibration determines the internal camera parameters and the relative poses of the cameras to one another. First, we create a HALCON calibration data model. It allows to use any number of cameras and calibration objects for a calibration and stores all calibration-related data. Next, we generate initial camera parameters. For the parameter focus, we generally use the focal length of the lens, which is usually written on the lens. It is given in meters. The distance between two neighboring cells on the sensor, also known as pixel pitch, can be found in the data sheet of the camera. The coordinates of the principal point of the image can be set like this initially. Then we set these camera parameters for the two identical cameras. Lastly, we specify the calibration plate we are using. You can obtain calibration plates from your local HALCON distributor. The appropriate size of the calibration plate depends on the field of view and the resolution of the camera. At least one finder pattern must be visible in every calibration image. Additionally, the diameter of the marks should be at least 20 pixels. Then we acquire a number of calibration images in a loop. Using the operator Find Calib Object, we locate the calibration marks and add them to the calibration model. Rules concerning the calibration images can be found in the HALCON Solution Guide on 3D Vision and in the chapter documentation of calibration. Have a look at both for extensive information on the subject of calibration. In particular, it's important to avoid overexposure and reflections. Here we store the current calibration information when clicking in the graphics window. For a successful calibration, you need to tilt the calibration plate in X and Y directions. On a related note, it's important to cover the complete 3D space that the objects will be located in. Additionally, make sure the calibration plate does not move during image acquisition to avoid motion blur and synchronization problems. Ideally, the cameras are triggered externally. Let's acquire some images. As a rule of thumb, 10 calibration images is a good number to perform a calibration and check the success. Having acquired the calibration images, we can call the operator Calibrate Cameras. The operator determines all camera parameters and returns the root mean square error of the back projection of this optimization in pixels. This error should be as small as possible, less than 1.0 is recommended for a stereo setup. Since we only use two cameras here, we can achieve a relatively low error. The error is likely to be larger when using more cameras. If this error is larger than 1, first check your initial camera parameters. Next, check that you specified the correct calibration plate. Additionally, check the quality of the calibration images, in particular the exposure and the focus. After the calibration, you often need only a subset of the calibration model, called the camera setup model. With this data, we can also use the procedure Gen Camera Setup Object Model 3D to visualize the calibrated camera setup, and thus check the camera calibration. Additionally, we calculate the epipolar error. But what does this value mean? Let's acquire some new images to visualize this. For better results, we turn the random pattern projector on. Here, I want to reconstruct my hand. First, the images are rectified using the calibration data. We'll see why in a moment. Let's introduce some new technical terms. The geometry of stereo vision is called epipolar geometry. The pair of image points that results from the projection of one object point into the two images is called conjugate points. The difference between the two image locations of the conjugate points is called the disparity. It is usually given in pixels. In the rectified images, all pairs of conjugate points have identical row coordinates. You can see here, for example, that the fingertips are on the same row. The aforementioned epipolar error describes the deviation of conjugate points in row direction in pixels. It should be smaller than 0.1 pixels for a successful stereo calibration. All results look good, so we can write the calibration data and the camera setup model to a file. And what can we do with this calibration data? With this local procedure, for example, we compute a disparity image and a 3D point cloud of our scene. This concludes the tutorial. You can download this HDevelop program and adapt it for your own stereo calibration. Thank you for watching.